talking with Tom York of Radiohead. Later next month at the Amphitheater, REM is coming back, and you know, while you're just starting your second decade, they're well into theirs. And you know what? I almost think sometimes now they're being taken for granted a little bit. I think we have to look back of this last generation of rock. I think, you know, they're as responsible as anybody for a lot of the ideals and a lot of influencing a lot of the great music over the last 20 years or so.
Well, they certainly influenced us. I mean, we did a show with them. We did Glastonbury in Britain, and they were on the previous night, and we were on the next night, and we sort of, I was too nervous actually to go to the show, so I watched it on TV, and it was really odd. I had all these memories coming back when they're playing in a Electrolyte and Finest Work song. It was just amazing. It looked so fantastic on TV as well. They got a new drummer now, and they're playing like the Finest Work song better than the record. It's just absolutely blinding. It's really exciting.
Of some of the later records, anyone like stick out as you as a favorite, like Up or something like that? Which I think Up's an underrated record.
Yeah, Up is. I don't know. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to sort of start saying what are my favorite records or what's not my favorite records, really. Mike might listening.
last October, you did the Neil Young's Bridge Show in San Francisco, and with the Foos and Ryan Adams and Tenacious D. Did you make any new friends at that show?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the meeting Neil Young was a big thing for me. I still can't. Yeah. Anyway, what can I say? it was a really nice vibe as well. They're very, very generous and very hospitable, and it was just it's a bit of a treat, really.
And people,
part of it.
And people were, you know, saying it was a rare solo show for you, but I don't know if you remember this. I hope you do, but it was March 28th, 95, right when the Bends came out. You came in town, we did an interview, then we took you down, and you did that nice solo acoustic show for us at the Horseshoe. You remember that?
No. Well, 1995, whoa. Yeah.
Talking with Tom York of Radiohead, what are some of your favorite cities that you've had a chance to see so much of the world? Anything that sticks out of you, the cities you really enjoy returning
anywhere
to?
In the world?
Yeah, what cities do you really enjoy?
Tokyo is my favorite. We've just been to Tokyo, and that's like, it's such a different culture. You leave and you kind of can't imagine, you kind of wake up in the middle of the night for the next week wondering whether it really happened or not. Because the time difference is so different as well, that night is day and day is night, and everything is a long way around, basically. And also, everybody's my height, which I really like.
That's... Talking with Tom York of Radiohead. When you guys did that webcast at Christmas, you weren't far off. It was kind of like, that's the way all television looked about a month later.
Why? What did we do? I can't remember. How do you mean?
When you guys dressed up like Saddam and...
Oh, yes, that.
Yes.
Yes. Mm.
Is it the end of the world as we know it?
No, it's just the loonies have taken over temporarily.
I don't know a lot about this, but I heard now you and Sigur Rós are both going to score a dance piece. Can you tell us about that?
It's not really sort of... if you could say scoring a dance piece, but that would be overdoing it a little bit. I think we've both got like 20 minutes to do whatever we want to do with the dance troupe. I can't remember the name now.
And is it going to be something that possibly might be recorded and we'll get to hear it, maybe?
Well, it's a really weird setup because, I mean, A, the dancers only get to hear what we're going to do once beforehand, and we don't know what we're going to do anyway. And then we have to show a bunch of musicians who are then going to take it out on tour, which is just all a little bit like, every time we sit down and discuss it, we're like, how are we going to do this? No idea. So it could be a complete disaster. But that's all right. That's kind of what they're into.
Talking with Tom York of Radiohead. I wanted to talk about the videos. We'll talk about we've all seen there lots, but we've just got a chance to see Go to Sleep here in the last day or so. Just explain the concept. It looks like it was like it could be like a, you know, an Xbox or a PlayStation game, but I'm not. Yeah. Really, explain how it was done.
Well, we basically used the same or the sort of live movement of all the, you know, all the human movement was actually pretty much done live, which meant wearing some peculiar bodysuit. So, you know, I'd sort of turned up expecting something vaguely resembling a video shoot, and there were no cameras at all or anything. It was really peculiar. And all the people who were working on it had never sort of done a video really before. It was just a lot of, like, really high-tech stuff. I mean, my involvement with the video was approximately 2 hours, which is fantastic. The rest was just number crunching. And it's a... I don't know, it was something I'd always wanted to try, really, getting heavily into that sort of Tron type thing.
And in the their video, did you just pick up the white coat and the boots and just put them on, and then they superimposed everything around you?
Unfortunately, no. It was a lot more hard work. It was like for me that was a 4-day shoot, which is the longest shoot I've done, and it was every shot was really heavily scripted. I mean, yeah, it was kind of like green screened, you know, like things were put on, but it wasn't easy. I had to move very, very, very slowly for 4 days, which actually kills you. It kills all the muscles in your back and stuff. It was pretty tough, actually. I have